Ciao ragazzi and welcome back to Lempi. So today is about Italy versus Germany.
Oh, I can see. Super excited.
Yeah,
yes.
Really.
You can tell from Ale's mood.
So I'm going to give you some reason why Italy, living in Italy is better than living in Germany.
Are you sure? So why are we not living in Italy if it's better?
Because Italy is perfect for living if you have money. Please let us know, would you rather prefer to live in Germany or
in
Italy?
I'm curious.
Yes.
Although for me I write Italy
all the time.
Yeah.
First point why Italy, living in Italy, it's better than living in Germany.
Ciao guys, we are really struggling to film this video.
I need to wait for my partner to get serious.
Wouldn't you want to just live in a place where you feel like you are in a vacation destination?
All the time.
And 2 hours away is another important vacation destination.
Yes.
Because I'm like, you live in Rome, and you just 2 hours away, you're in Napoli. And
wow.
Then a few hours away, you're in Venice. And then a few hours away, you're in Milan. So
yeah.
It's like topped. Another few hours, you're in Sardinia.
Yeah, that is another fact.
It's
like, the country is small, so everything is so compact, and within 2 hours
but
you can reach another city.
Most of those places are very beautiful. You like have a vacation destination hotspot.
Yeah.
And that is the reason why living there is definitely better than
living
here.
Germany. No.
Definitely better. Just like when I say it now, even more prominent in my mind.
In your mind.
It's true because like
we should live in Italy.
We might end up moving.
Because
I'm
thinking, we have bought a house.
Yeah, I know. It's not even on my mind now, but I'm thinking, you're definitely in Rome.
Mm-hmm.
In Rome, 2 hours you're in Napoli. It's a completely different environment, different.
Yeah. Or
different food, different
everything.
Vibe. Then you have Sardinia on the other side. Then
you
have also
Sicily. You have Puglia. You have Calabria. You have Molise.
Venice.
But for example, we haven't together like the part of Italy that we haven't visited yet is the north part. But they are amazing, like Lago di Garda, Lago di Como. They are amazing places. All the Alps.
We have visited Lago di Garda.
Yes, but just passing by one night. Come on.
Yeah, one night.
Okay. Anyway, yes, a country that always make you feel like you are on holiday. Wouldn't
Germany or Italy?
Italy for sure.
Italy for sure is better for that. Oh. Now, I would say this is my number one reason why living in Italy is better. And because I think this is what I hate most about living in Germany. The weather.
The weather, yes.
I mean, I have to look at, we are in mid-July, and outside, the whole week, it has been just gray and rainy and gloomy and dark. It almost feels like
Yeah, it feels like autumn.
Like
I don't know. If I think about, okay, I look at the calendar, is July, is mid-July. Okay, it's 8 o'clock, I want to go buy groceries. I go out with a t-shirt because it's July, come on, it's summer. And I literally freeze out then. That much that I need to go back and take a coat or take a jacket.
Yeah, because the temperature is 14 or 10.
Yes, it's 10, like 12. And then it's covered and then it's windy.
And it's rainy.
And I have my hair wet, so I definitely going to get headache. I need to go back and get a coat.
Yes. I just prefer the weather condition better in Italy. It's more, for me as an African, it's nicer, it's warmer. It's a little bit more sunny, you have more light there.
Little bit more sunny. I don't know. Literally, how many Christmas did you spend in Italy? Of all the Christmas that you have spent in Italy, how many are there where they were cloudy?
No, I can't tell that.
I don't know. I want to say most
of those who doesn't dream about living in Italy or visiting Italy. Italian food. Everybody know how delicious, buonissimo.
Yes.
The food is. So number one on our list
Is food.
It's food. Because, I mean, I don't know if you like food, if you really like food, you know, it just
that
lightens
is
your heart. It makes you happy. So I'm thinking I'm always in good mood when I'm eating.
Yes, and we are so proud of our food culture. Like when you are talking and you are eating, you're talking about eating. Like, I don't know any other country that is like that in the world. It's just like we are always at the center of our culture is really about food. It's not even our, like, you know, all the monuments and the art that there is in the country. Of course, it's also about that, but it's really centered about food. Food is our, like, 50% of our culture, basically.
Food, here we are talking about variety. The country is small. If I'm thinking, if I'm comparing this to Namibia or comparing it to Germany, it's quite small. But you could say when you're in Rome, you have so many dishes that are just really Romano.
Mm-hmm.
Nice and different than if you drive 2 hours away and go to Napoli and still find something
it's completely different.
And that is, this is why I'm living in Italy, is better, because I'm thinking of a pizza Napolitana with mozzarella.
That is nice.
And basilicum. Mozzarella di bufala and basilicum, and I'm talking of
Or pastiera napoletana,
yes.
Sfogliatella, or so many other things that just thinking about, or limoncello, di Sorrento.
So those things are very nice, and on the other side of the food, I'm also thinking about the quality of the produce that you find in the market when you're looking to do something at home, to make something at home.
Yes.
You have also access to really good quality
like
products.
Good product quality.
You have so many historic places to visit.
Mm-hmm.
Especially just for weekend, you know? Weekend.
Yeah,
travels.
No. That is something that is another thing that is incredible about Italy. We have something about 72% of the entire world monuments and history. Yeah, 72% is something that I don't even know. Like, when you hear it, you don't think it's real.
But small. Wow.
Yeah, well, it's so small, but we have so many historical things and, I don't know, monuments and paintings
and
art from ancient Roman history. And it's just, I don't know, it's just full. We are packed. We have so many things that our museum basement are enough, like, contain enough art that can fill Europe, probably a lot of museum around all around the world. And that is also another thing that you can really find here in Germany.
How open the people and how just you in Italy is like characters. You just meet and have a conversation. People are just more open-minded. The mindset is more like just socializing with others and enjoying life.
Yes.
Dolce Vita. What is it called?
Dolce Vita is everywhere. That is our philosophy.
It's everywhere
it does,
in Italy.
Yes, it just, we are like that. Like, yeah, work is important, but,
but
not really. You should be enjoying life. You should have free time. You shouldn't be too taking yourself too seriously. It's like, it's an Italian thing. And also, you need to spend a lot of time with people that matter to you. Like, family is so central. And, you know, you have to visit your family and, you know, have at least once or two meetings a month.
When you're partying.
And what you are doing, you are eating, of course, because we are Italian. So what do we do when we met? We eat. And so on. And that is... It's another aspect of Italian culture that I find it better than German.
You have seen it for the good weather, for the good food, for a nice vacation destination. Living in Italy is absolutely better than living in Germany. However, there are also some other reasons where living in Germany is better, and that's why we have a series about living in Germany.
We are going to live here.
And look at my pointer.
Exactly. Up here, if you want to check why we are living in Germany.
As usual, if you enjoy this video,
give us a like.
Subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to leave a comment in the description box below.
Ciao.